Now I need to check whether this function is continuous at x equal to 5. If denominator becomes 0, then function will not be defined. If limit extends to a f of x value is equal to f of a, then we say the function is continuous. You got LHL as 2, you got RHL as 2, and you got f of 2 also as 2, f of 1 also as 2. So if LHL, RHL, f of a, if all three are equal, then we say function is continuous. Welcome to the session, dear students. In my last class, I taught you the basic concepts of limits. And now in today's class, we'll go for continuity. See, when I draw a graph of any function, you can decide whether it's continuous at given point or not. Without drawing graph, using the tool called limits, we can decide whether the function is continuous or not. Now, first, how to define continuity of a function? When I take any function, a real function f of x is said to be continuous at x is equal to a if limit extends to a f of x value is same as f of a. If limit extends to a f of x value is equal to f of a, then we say the function is continuous. For example, if I take f of x is equal to 5x plus 3. Now, if I ask you to check whether this is continuous at x is equal to 1. I'm asking you to check whether the function is continuous at x is equal to 1. No need to draw the graph. The graph of this is a straight line. So now what we'll do? We'll apply limit extends to, we are checking continuity at what? 1. Limit extends to 1 f of x when you apply. What is meant by limit extends to 1 f of x? So that is limit extends to 1. Apply for the given function 5x plus 3. When you apply limit, you'll get extends to 1 means in the place of x put 1, 5 into 1 plus 3, that will become 8. So therefore, we got a unique or specific value. And if you find f of 1, what is f of 1? In the place of x put 1, it will become 5 into 1 plus 3, that is also 8. You can see limit extends to 1 f of x is also 8 and f of 1 is also 8. Therefore, the conclusion is what? Limit extends to 1 f of x value is same as f of 1 value. Therefore, the function is continuous. So, using the limit technique, limit extends to a f of x value, if it is equal to f of a, then we say the function is continuous at a. This is a simple technique to decide whether the function is continuous or not. What are the basic formula? Limit extends to a f of x when you apply, you should get f of a. Or limit extends to a f of x value and f of a value, if both are same, then we say function is continuous at the point called a. And all the polynomial functions are continuous for real numbers. And now this is also a polynomial function, this is a linear function. So it is also, and x is equal to 1 is a real number. Every polynomial function is continuous at real numbers, remember this. Now, check whether the function f of x is equal to 3x square minus 2 is continuous at x equal to 5. They gave a function. Clearly, the function is polynomial function of degree 2. I told you, polynomial functions are always continuous. Now, I need to check whether this function is continuous at x equal to 5. How to check is very simple. Apply, find limit extends to, we want to check continuity at what? 5. So, apply limit extends to 5 f of x. Limit extends to 5 f of x, that is equal to limit extends to 5. What is f of x? F of x they gave 3x square minus 2. So limit extends to 5, 3x square minus 2. Now in the place of x put 5, it will become 3 into 5 square minus 2. That is, further if you simplify, 5 square is 25. 25 into 3 is 75 minus 2. That will become 73. So now we got limit value as 73. Now you find f of 5. F of 5 means what? In 3x square minus 2, in the place of x put 5, it will become 3 into 5 square minus 2. 3 into 25 minus 2. 3 into 25 is 75 minus 2. Again you will get 73. So therefore, both the cases you got 73. So you can say, therefore, limit extends to 5 f of x value is same as f of 5. Therefore, f of x
means the given function is continuous. You can decide it is continuous at x is equal to what? 5. So when we have function with one value, so now they give function f of x is 3x square minus 2 and they are asking you to check whether it is continuous at 5. So what you should do, apply limit x tends to 5 f of x, you will get 73 as the answer. Then you find f of 5, that also will give you 73. Therefore, what is the conclusion? Limit x tends to 5 f of x value is same as f of 5 value. Therefore, we can say the given function f of x is continuous at x is equal to the real number 5. And I told you polynomial functions, this is a polynomial functions, are always continuous for real values. This is a real value. Next. Now, check whether the function f of x is equal to x plus 5 by x minus 3 is continuous at x is equal to 6. Now, they want you to check whether this function is continuous at x is equal to what? 6. What is the method? Method is simple. Apply limit. Limit x tends to a, that is x tends to 6, because we want to check continuity at 6. So apply limit x tends to what? 6. If they ask you to check continuity at 7, apply limit x tends to 7. But here they want you to check limit at what? 6. Or they want you to check continuity at 6. So limit x tends to 6 f of x you apply, that is equal to limit x tends to 6. F of x means function value. What is function value? X plus 5 by x minus 3. X plus 5 divided by x minus 3. Now in the place of x, put 6. In the place of x, if I put 6, I'll get 6 plus 5 by 6, sorry, 6 plus 5 by 6 minus 3. 6 plus 5 is 11 by 3. So now we got limit value as 11 by 3. Now separately find f of 6. If you find f of 6, that is 6 plus 5 by 6 minus 3. 6 plus 5 is 11, 11 by 3. So both are equal. Therefore, what is the conclusion? Therefore, limit x tends to 6 value. Limit x tends to 6 f of x value is same as f of x. Therefore, f is continuous. Therefore, f is what? Continuous. Not at all points. At x is equal to what? 6. Now, same question. So now I've done this. Same question. This is a rational function. Numerator by denominator. Polynomial by polynomial. But this is rational function. We have numerator and denominator. The same function is not always continuous. See, now the same function, I'll talk about the same function. At x is equal to 3, if they ask, at x is equal to 3, denominator becomes 3 minus 3, 0. At x is equal to 3, function is not defined. If function is not defined, then it's not continuous. So, if they ask at 3, now they're not asking at 3, they're asking at 6. And at 6, limit extends to 6, f of x value and f of 6 value both are same. Therefore, I can conclude the function is continuous. Now, going ahead. The function f of x is equal to 1 by x minus 5. They gave a function f of x is equal to 1 by x minus 5. They are asking you to check whether f is continuous. Check f is continuous at x is equal to 5. And also they are asking you to justify the statement. So now, whenever there is a polynomial function, whenever there is a rational function, observe the denominator. Denominator should not become 0. If denominator becomes 0, then function will not be defined. And that too, they are asking you to check at 5. So now, here, at x is equal to 5, at x is equal to 5, f of x is not defined. F of x is not defined. At x is equal to 5, f of x is not defined. Since it is not defined, why? Because if I take x as 5, it will become 1 by 5 minus 5, it will become 1 by 0, it will become not defined. It will become what? Not defined. Therefore, at x is equal to 5, f of x is not defined. Therefore, f of x is not continuous. When function is not defined, definitely it is not continuous. So now, no need to check the continuity. No need to apply limit, because function does not exist at x equal to 5. At x is equal to 5, denominator becomes 0. If denominator is 0, it will become not defined. So, the function f of x is equal to 1 by x minus 5 is given. They are asking you to check at 5. At 5, f of x is not defined, because denominator becomes 0. Denominator should not become 0. So, therefore, at 5, the function is not continuous. So answer is f of x is not continuous because at x is equal to 5 function is not defined. Next we have continuity in other terms. So now I took simple problem where f of x has one value. Now f of x, if it is having more than one functional value, we call it as piecewise function. When f of x is having more than one value, then you should find LHL, that you know in 11th left handed limit, then you should find RHL right handed limit, then you should find f of a. If LHL, RHL, f of a, if all three are equal, then we say function is continuous. So a function in type 2, function will have more than one value. So we have to find left handed limit, then we have to find right handed limit, then we have to find f of a. If left handed limit, right handed limit and f of a, if all three are equal, then we say the function is continuous at x is equal to a. For example, I will take a simple problem. First, what is LHL? What is LHL? Left handed limit. What is left handed limit? Limit x tends to a minus f of x. Limit x tends to a minus f of x. What does it mean? Suppose we have a function with more than one value. So I am taking a function with more than one value. F of x value is g of x when x is less than a, and it is h of x when x is greater than a, and it is l of x when x is equal to a. Okay? So now function is having how many values? Function is g of x when x is less than a, f of x is h of x when x is greater than a, and f of x is l of x when x is equal to a. So function is having three values depending on the value of x. So now LHL means left handed limit. What is the full form of LHL? Left handed limit. What is left handed limit? Limit x tends to a minus f of x. What does it mean? It is same as limit x tends to a. Limit x tends to what? A. Minus means choose the function. Choose f of x when x is less than a. When x is less than a, what is f of x? When x is less than a, f of x is g of x. X tends to a minus is same as x tends to a. In the place of f of x, choose a function when x is less than a. When x is less than a, what is f of x? G of x. Now apply limit. X tends to a means in the place of x you put a, or apply limit. Then RHL. What is meant by RHL? Right handed limit. Right handed limit means what? Limit extends to a plus f of x. Limit extends to a plus f of x. What does it mean? It is same as limit extends to a. Limit extends to a plus is same as limit extends to a. But choose the function when x is greater than a. When x is greater than a, what is the function? H of x. So in the place of f of x, choose the f of x value. F of x is having three values. Out of the three values, you choose f of x when x is greater than a. When x is greater than a, it is h of x. Now apply limit and then you find f of a. F of a means what? Functional value when x is a. When x is a, it is l of x. Now in the place of x, put what? A, like that. So when function is having more than one value like this, f of x is g of x, h of x, l of x, like that, if it is having more than one value, we call it as piecewise function. When it is a piecewise function, you should find LHL, you should find RHL, you should find f of a. For p, see, first case, when you go back to the slides, in the first case we took simple one function with one value, but here function is piecewise. F of x is having more than one value. When f of x is piecewise function, then you should find LHL, then you should find RHL, then you should find f of a. If LHL, RHL, f of a, if all three are same, then function is continuous. When can you say function is continuous? If LHL, RHL, f of a, all three should be same. What is LHL? Left handed limit. What is left handed limit? Limit extends to a minus f of x. What does it mean? It is same as limit extends to a. Minus means choose the function when x is less than a. When x is less than a, f of x value is what? G of x, choose it. That's it. Then you go for RHL. What is RHL? Limit extends to a plus f of x. What is the meaning of limit extends to a plus? It is same as limit extends to a, but plus means choose the function when x is greater than a. When x is greater than a, f of x is h of x. Then find f of a functional value at a. If all three are same, then function is continuous. When can you say function is continuous? If left handed limit, right handed limit and functional value at a, if all three are equal, then we say the function is continuous at a. Now we'll go ahead with some interesting problem. Check whether f of x is equal to x square plus 1 when x is less than 1, 2x when x is greater than 1, x plus 1 when x equal to 1 is continuous. Whether this is continuous at x is equal to 1 or not. They're asking you to check whether the function is continuous or not. Can I say f of x is piecewise function. F of x is having more than one value. Now we need to check at one. So first find LHL. What is meant by LHL? Left-handed limit. What is LHL? Left-handed limit. What is LHL formula? Limit extends to a minus f of x. A means the point where you are checking continuity. So limit extends to, in this problem we need to check continuity at what? 1. So in spite of a minus, take what? Limit extends to 1 minus f of x. What is the meaning of this? Limit extends to 1 minus means it is same as limit extends to 1. But minus means choose the function when x is less than 1. When x is less than 1, what is the function? X square plus 1. When x is less than 1, f of x is x square plus 1. So now I took LHL. What is LHL formula? Limit extends to a minus f of x. So now in this problem, a is what? 1. If you are checking continuity at 1, you take 1 minus. If they want you to check continuity at 5, then take 5 minus. But here they want you to check continuity at 1, so limit extends to 1 minus f of x. What is the meaning of 1 minus? It is same as 1. Limit extends to 1. Minus means choose the function when x is less than 1. When x is less than 1, the function is x square plus 1. Now limit extends to 1, x square plus 1. Apply the limit. What is m extends to 1? In the place of x put 1, it will become 1 square plus 1. What is 1 square plus 1? 2. Now you got LHL. What you got? LHL. What is LHL value you got? LHL is exactly 2. Now you go for RHL. What is RHL? Right handed limit. How to find right handed limit? That is limit extends to a plus f of x. In this case, that is limit extends to 1 plus f of x. What does it mean? It is same as limit extends to 1. Plus means choose the function when x is greater than 1. When x is greater than 1, what is function? 2x. Now apply limit. Limit extends to 1, 2x means what? In the place of x put 1, 2 into 1. 2 into 1 is what? 2. Now we got RHL. RHL value is what? 2. We got already LHL. LHL is 2. Now we got RHL. RHL is also 2. Find f of 1. F of 1 means function value when x is 1. When x is 1, what is the function value? X plus 1. So now in the place of x put 1, 1 plus 1, it is 2. So now therefore, your LHL value, RHL value, f of 1, all are same. You got LHL as 2, you got RHL as 2, and you got f of 2 also as 2, f of 1 also as 2. So therefore, given function f of x is continuous. Now I can conclude the given function is continuous at x is equal to 1. So let me repeat the whole process. They want you to check whether the f of x is continuous at x equal to 1. They want you to check continuity at what? 1. And f of x is having more than one functional value. We call it as piecewise function. F of x is x square plus 1 when x is less than 1. F of x is 2x when x is greater than 1. F of x is x plus 1 when x equal to 1. So now f of x is having more than one value. So now you should find LHL, RHL, f of a. If all three are equal, then we say the function is continuous. So first find LHL. What is LHL? LHL means left-handed limit. Means we are approaching the x value from left side. A number line if I draw, we have a. We can reach a from left side or we can reach from right side. Means taking less than a values reach a. That is LHL. Taking higher values reach a. That is RHL. But here the process is simple. Limit extends to a minus f of x. What is LHL? Limit extends to a minus f of x. What does it mean? It is same as limit extends to 1 minus f of x, because we are checking continuity at 1. In spite of a, write what? 1 minus f of x. What is the meaning of limit extends to 1 minus? It is same as limit extends to 1. Limit extends to 1 minus is same as limit extends to 1. But minus means choose the function when x is less than 1. When x is less than 1, the function is x square plus 2. So in the place of f of x, put x square plus 1 and apply limit. In the place of x, put 1, you will get 2. Then RHL. What is RHL? Right-handed limit. That is limit extends to a plus f of x. Here it is 1 plus f of x. So what is meant by limit extends to 1 plus? Limit extends to 1 plus is same as limit extends to 1, but plus means choose the function when x is greater than 1. When x is greater than 1, the function is 2x. In the place of f of x, put 2x. Now in the place of x, put 1, 2 into 1 is 2. You got RHL. Then you find f of a. F of a means in this case it is f of 1. F of 1 means when x is equal to 1, f of x values x plus 1, right? X plus 1. In the place of x, put 1. So you'll get 2. So if you see LHL value, RHL value, and f of 1 value, all three are same. So therefore we say function is continuous. When can you say function is continuous? If LHL, RHL, f of a, all three are equal, then we say the function is continuous. Here the function is continuous at x is equal to 1. I hope all of you understood. This is second type of problem. In first type of problem, it was very simple. They'll give f of x one value and we have to check the continuity. And I took two polynomial functions. I told you polynomial functions are always continuous for all real numbers. Then I took some rational function. Rational function means what? Numerator by denominator. If denominator becomes zero, then the function is not defined. If function is not defined, then it will not be continuous. Then I took the next type, that is piecewise function. Function with more than one value. When you have function with more than one value, then you have to take LHL, RHL and f of a. If LHL, RHL and f of a, if all three are equal, then we say function is continuous. So now in today's class, I started the basic topic called continuity. Continuity for your board exam, important. One 4-mark question is compulsory for second PUC board exam. In part E section, they will have 6 plus 4 marks. You refer the past previous year papers, they are asking a 4-mark question from continuity. So in part E, you will have 6 plus 4 marks and this 4-mark question will be from what? Continuity. So the basic topic I started today, and tomorrow we'll be discussing all the 4-mark problems that will appear for your board exams. So in my next session, I'll be going for 4-markers. Today, to demonstrate and to make you understand, I've done type 1. In type 1, f of x will have one value. F of x will have how many values? One value. How to prove continuity? Just we'll do limit extends to a f of x, and if that value is same as f of a, if limit extends to a f of x is equal to f of a, then we say f of x is continuous. So this is the one basic thing. And other than that, in type 2 what we have done? In type 2 we have done LHL, then we have done RHL, then we have done f of a. So in type 2, f of x will have more than one value. F of x will have what? More than one value. When f of x is having more than one value, so then what we should do? We have to find LHL, then we have to find RHL, then we have to find f of a. If all three are equal, then we say function is continuous. And what is LHL? What is LHL? Left-handed limit. What is the formula for LHL? Limit extends to a minus f of x. What does it mean? It is same as limit extends to a, but choose the function when x is less than a. Then I taught you what is RHL. What is RHL? Limit extends to a plus f of x. What does it mean? It is same as limit extends to a, but choose the function when x is greater than a. These are the basic concepts we discussed in today's class. I started with basic. See, in my last session, I taught you how to apply limit. I recapitulated whatever you learnt in 11th standard or first year PUC. In today's session, I started with basic continuity. Nowhere we have drawn graph. We have used tool called limits to check whether the function is continuous. Type 1, if limit extends to a f of x is same as f of a, then we say function is continuous. Type 2, if LHL, RHL, f of a, if all three are equal, then we say the function is continuous. Now we'll go ahead with more problems. I told you in part E section 1, 4-marker question as a sub question in 10 marks will come from continuity. That we'll be discussing in my next session. So thanks for attending the session. I'll see you in my next session. Thank you.